We all have an idea of the happiness that love will bring us. Most of us put the search for love at the very centre of our lives. And yet it's a subject on which philosophy is strangely silent. Given that few of our experiences feel more life-changing or more important, one might have thought that philosophers would take love very seriously, but on the whole, they haven't.
They see it as a subject that's probably better left to poets, hysterics, and chat show hosts on daytime TV. But there was one philosopher who did take love very seriously. He saw it as one of our central concerns. His name was Arthur Schopenhauer.
In an admittedly rather unromantic field, Schopenhauer is the one philosopher who seems to understand the intensity of what we feel when we fall in love. He thought we were absolutely right to build our lives around love. Nothing else in life was quite as important. But the mistake he thought we made was to imagine that happiness had anything to do with it.
Dear Michelle, I cannot do this anymore. You know what you want, and I know that I do not want to marry you. It's unfair on you and me to continue anymore. I'm so unhappy in the relationship, which I didn't know that. I thought you was happy. And it seems that however hard I try to look into the future positively, the situation does not feel right. By the time you read this, I'll have left for a month or two travelling. It's so hard, but I'm not the right one for you, nor you for me.
That's terrible. So.
And then a PS, please don't try and call, it's too upsetting. And I haven't seen or spoken to him since.
So what was your first reaction when you read this?
I just burst into tears. What do you expect? I chucked myself in the loo and cried.
You got a letter at
work. Michelle Hutchison's boyfriend of 4 years left this letter, along with all her things from his flat, in a plastic bag at reception where she works.
And did you try and call him? Did you didn't
no.
You didn't have any way of getting in touch with him?
No, I did. I knew his numbers. But I didn't want to speak to him after that. I thought, this is it. I can't get myself out of this situation. I can't make him want me. That's so obviously clear that he doesn't want me.
Tell me a bit more about him. I mean, what's he like? What does he do? How did you meet? That sort of thing.
We met through a friend of mine that I lived with at university, and she introduced us at a party, and I practically moved in on the first date.
What, how come?
Because it was the summer holiday, so I'd just finished my degree. Mm-hmm. And he said, come down for the weekend. And I actually never left. We went back and got the rest of my stuff, and I ended up living there.
And was it kind of legendary love at first sight? Did you lay eyes on him and you just thought...
It was for me. At this party, we were walking across the field, and I just felt so comfortable with him.
Do you think that he loved you?
I think he did.
So in that case, why this letter, if he loved you? I mean, I'm not saying he didn't.
He loved me, but love isn't enough, is it?
At first glance, it's hard to believe that Schopenhauer could really understand the pain that Michelle is going through, or have anything helpful to say to anyone in her situation. He never married, lived alone, and was often bitterly misogynistic. But go to Frankfurt and take a look around the Schopenhauer archive with archivist and keeper of the Schopenhauer in Flame, Joachim Stolberg. There, amongst the rather poignant bits and pieces of Schopenhauer's life, you begin to get a picture of a man who truly deserves the title of philosophy's Dr. Love. Schopenhauer was born in Danzig in 1788, but spent most of his life here in Frankfurt. From an early age, he looked to love for happiness. He was intelligent, confident, good-looking, and after his father died when he was 17, extremely rich.
That's him. That's a great man.
But success with women eluded him.
And his own signature. And that's the earliest. Mm-hmm. That's the earliest photo that we have of him.
Yeah.
With a moustache. I've forgotten the German for moustache again. What's German for moustache?
Schnauzbart.
Schnauzbart. So he's got a Schnauzbart on. And he's how old?
Schnurrbart.
Schnurrbart.
Yeah.
And how old is he there?
21.
What, 21? And he's writing his thesis.
Vincesimo primo.
He's writing his thesis. He's interested in women. He's trying to meet them, but has problems meeting them.
Okay.
And back. Was he attractive to women?
War attraktiv für Frauen?
Vielleicht, ja.
A kleiner.
Ja, kleiner als wir. Kleiner,
ja?
Ja, kleiner
viel,
als wir.
Viel kleiner.
Viel kleiner. Man sieht es an dem Spazierstock.
Ah, okay.
Wir können ihn herausnehmen.
So he was quite a small philosopher, which meant that anyone with theories of small men
has plenty to feed on with Schopenhauer.
Die Handschrift von Caroline Medon.
So these are the letters from Caroline Medon, who was...
In 1821, at the age of 33, he did meet a woman who liked him, a 19-year-old singer called Caroline Medon. But he was never comfortable enough in the relationship to settle down.
Mein lieber Arthur. So she was very warm.
She
wasn't desperate. She had choice, but she fell in love with him. And they had a child together. She was very keen on marriage, but he didn't want to.
He told her, for two people to get married means to do everything possible to become an object of disgust to one another.
Mein innigst geliebter guter Arthur.
Ever warmer letters.
After 10 stormy years, the relationship broke up. Schopenhauer continued to search for love, but with ever less success. In 1831, he developed a passion for Flora Weiss, a beautiful, spirited girl who had just turned 17. During a boating party, in an attempt to charm her, Schopenhauer started talking to her about his philosophy. He smiled and offered her a bunch of grapes. Flora later confided in her diary, "I didn't want them. I felt revolted because old Schopenhauer had touched them, so I let them slide quite gently into the water behind me." Towards the end of his life, he did enjoy a contentment of sorts with an attractive sculptress and admirer of his philosophy, Elizabeth Nye, who came to Frankfurt to make a bust of him. But it was hardly the culmination of the happy romantic life that the young Arthur Schopenhauer had dreamt of.
She's quite pretty. Did he like her?
Es scheint so. Und hat so intime Dinge geäußert, wie dass glücklich gewesen sei, auf dem Sofa gemeinsam mit der Künstlerin Kaffee zu trinken.
They had a very happy time when Elizabeth was making this portrait of him, sculpture of him. Mm-hmm. They had a lovely time. They sat on the sofa and had coffee together.
Yeah.
And they behaved like a married couple,
yeah,
he said.
Yeah.
And did he like this portrait of him?
Schopenhauer hat es sehr geliebt, dieses Portrait.
He really liked it.
Und
but his friends seemed to notice that there was a disparity between his head, which looks very much the head of a 71-year-old, and the body, which looks like a sort of athletic, wie er 21 wäre, as though he was a 21-year-old hero. No wonder he liked it.
So how could this romantically hapless philosopher have anything wise to tell us about love? Well, for a